Welcome to everyone. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. And we are here, alhamdulillah, with the blessings of our Sheikh, with the Holy Ones. Let me tell you a small story. 15 years ago, I came to this country to go to graduate school at Columbia University. I came all the way from Far East Asia, because in Far East Asia, we were taught that in order to find life, you must go to where the sun is setting, in the west. So I came here, in the west, to Columbia University, where at first I didn't know, to tell you frankly, it's an Ivy League school. I went there, and I lived there in New York City, and I'm looking at the lifestyle, and I'm trying to fit myself to that, to like it, forcing myself to. And to tell you sincerely, it didn't fit. Something was missing. Something was not gluing properly. So, from Far East Asia, I was also looking for that glue. Unknowingly, I came to the West to look for that glue. And alhamdulillah, before long, I found that glue with our Sheikh, with my Sheikh. I'm only saying this to you not to praise myself, but to say that I'm not coming from some village or some mountain. I'm not looking down on them too, because now I live in a village and in a mountain. And I know how difficult it is, how much intelligence it is to live in those kind of conditions, which is the conditions of the Prophet والسلام, the conditions of the Sahibi Kiram, and the conditions of the Awliya Allah. So I came and I saw our Sheikh sitting one day in New York City in a basement, very stuffy day, summertime, like this. And I saw him sitting. I was looking for a Sufism, and I saw Islam. And I looked and I saw him, and for the first time in my life, wallahi. I'm seeing someone who's practicing Islam, who's loving that religion. He's not apologizing for that religion. He's not ashamed for that religion. He's not saying, I am American Muslim, American first instead of Muslim, or Pakistani Muslim, or Turkish Muslim. I'm a Muslim. And I felt relieved. I felt happy. Because Prophet ﷺ is so far away from us, from me, 1400 years ago. But when I looked at him, he's representing that one. He is not that one, but he's representing that one. And for the first time in my life, and I'm speaking for the behalf of so many of us here, for the first time in our lives, we are feeling that we're living as if we're in the presence of the Holy Prophet ﷺ. We are not comparing ourselves to them. We're very far away from them, but we're tasting a little bit. We're tasting also that glue, that we're putting Allah and His Prophet first. And when we look at Him, He is putting Allah and the Prophet first, alayhi salatu wasalam. So we feel comfortable, and we sit, and we didn't come yesterday, we came years. We sit and we observe, and we sit and we judge, and we sit and we look, and as the years go by, we came to understand more and more what our Sheikh is representing. What is he striving for? What is the vision that he has? What is it that he's trying to make our life to turn to? Holy Prophet ﷺ, our Prophet is saying so many times, he did not come to the world to teach his people, the Ummah, us, the dunya, but to bring them to Akhirah. And when I sit with him, I'm feeling that I'm not connected to this dunya. The burdens that I have is passing, and I feel comfortable. The burdens that I have, the problems that I have, seem small, because now I understand what Allah wants from me and how I can be a servant, and that brings peace to me, that brings strength to me. So just as 1400 years ago, Holy Prophet also came, and he came and he brought people together whose heart is together. and he came for the sake of haq. That is how we are seeing our sheikh. That is how we are seeing how he is serving his sheikh. And how they are serving their sheikh for 1400 years, unbroken lineage. And we are feeling very happy and very grateful to be part of this lineage. It is not through our efforts, it is not through our sitting down and praying so much or making zikr so much. But we are thirsty for something, and our sheikh is providing us that. Alhamdulillah. I just like to take this opportunity, because this marriage here, this is a glue. These two people here, they are glued. But what is that glue that is holding them together? If it is dunya, it will pass. And the end is not so good maybe. If it is the nafs, it will pass. The ending is not so good. But if they're coming for the sake of Allah and His Prophet, for the sake of Allah, obeying His Prophet, and obeying His rightful guided leaders, this is Quran saying, then that glue is a rock, and it will endure inshallah here and hereafter. I'm sorry for speaking so much.
Welcome to you.